In this video, we're going to cover how to run the PATH 2018 export for the PATH Data Exchange submission. Under HMIS Reports, hover over HUD/HMIS Reports, and click on 2018 PATH Annual Report. There are certain report criteria that you will need to select before you can run the export. First, set your report date range. What I have here might be different than what you might enter yourself based on your grants. Your organization should already be selected for you. And it's not necessary to select the grant, but you can by clicking on the grant checkbox. Then select the program you are running the export for. Click Run Export on the bottom right-hand corner of the screen when you're done. You will be taken to the Export Encryption box. You have two options here. If you leave the Encrypt Export box checked, you will be required to create a password for your export. It doesn't have to be your client track password, but it can be. When you go this route, what is actually downloaded is a small .exe or executable file, which extracts the files into a zip folder, and I'll show you what that looks like a little later. If you uncheck the Encrypt Export box, then you get this warning message, and you'll need to check this little box in order to continue. When you go this route, then what downloads is the .zip file. There are no additional steps to go through. And this is the option you want to go with if your computer has a security setting that does not allow it to download executable files from the internet. Regardless of what option you choose, you are still responsible for the security of the data you download. Leave the include header row in CSV files box checked, and the always quote CSV values box unchecked. Once you are through, select Done. You will be taken to the Files on Server page. Now, you can already see here that I have my files. But typically, these files can take an hour or longer to download. While the data is downloading, you can use the system as normal. You can come back to this page by clicking on the Files on Server menu option. Notice the difference between the two types of files. This one has .exe at the end, and this one has .zip. Please be aware that PATH Data Exchange will not accept the .exe file as it is. You will need to go through an additional step that I'll walk you through right now. Click on the paper and arrow icon to download the file. I have Windows Defender on my computer, and you might have something similar, so I need to tell my computer to allow this to run anyway. You will then need to input the password you created, check the box that says I assume responsibility, and then you can select where the files will download by clicking on the ellipsis icon on the far right. I suggest that you place them in a folder that you create before running the export. Once these files are sent to the folder, you will need to zip them by clicking on the first file, holding down the Shift key, and clicking on the last file. Right-click on your highlighted files, Send to Compressed Zip Folder. This zip file is what you will upload to PATH Data Exchange. Let's go back to the Files on Server page. If you did not go the encryption route, then what actually exported was a .zip file. Download the file. It will likely be sent to your Downloads folder, and you can move it to another location on your computer. But once the file is downloaded, you're ready to upload it to PATH Data Exchange, no additional steps required. Thanks for watching.